When you bombing as a pastor, you got to get it. If y'all don't hear me, y'all laugh. I'm just saying this, all right? My whole life has just been all over the place, okay? Especially my diet. That's why I'm off, because I can eat what I want now, and I grew up on government food, like most people in here. You know, remember the box of food, the... So I got my stuff from the church, so you know, church and house and all that was mixed with those things when I was a kid. I gave them a little box of food. I hated the silver can with the pig. They called pork all the beef on it. It's just was silver and gravy already, like... Just put the gravy on it, like, anybody remember bones in this? You just had bones and meat parts in a can. So this one scared me. When the last time they canned meat? Anybody, you ain't never ate no canned meat to this. It was bad in my house. Like, if I came to your house to eat and you had, like, cheese in the sliced wrappers, I was like, dang, they rich. That's what I called my mom. Said, I'm eating here tonight. I'm eating. I just hate that they used to act like they had money when they know we didn't. This is what really made me mad. I saved to get my own box of cereal. I got tired of the fruit rounds. I got tired of the cinnamon toast crunch. The fake cinnamon toast smash. I got tired of Sergeant Crunch. I want a real Captain Crunch, not Sergeant Crunch. I don't want no big bag of Popeye's oats. I didn't want that. Saved up. Got my own box of cereal. No, we're talking about when you're a little kid. Come on, Cookie Crisp, remember, that was like the top of the line, $5 box cereal. So I saved and got me a box of Cookie Crisp. I was like, ooh, and then I was like, ghetto selfish, put the box under my bed. You know what I mean? When I got my box out, poured me a real nice helping of milk, but somebody put powder milk in the regular milk container. Now I got this light-skinned water all over my Cookie Crisp. Just tell us the truth. Tell us we ain't got it. We poor. Yeah, right. I wanted to join the gang. I read too much. You know, I did. I tried to join the gang, but I was really, really smart. Like, I understood poppy value really early. So the first gang meeting didn't work out. They was like, hey, you gonna die for this block? Not this block in particular. Retail value is atrocious. I know it's my first day gang banging, but I suggest we move the gang to the Gold Coast. The Gold Coast gangsters. The neighborhood is to die for. At least come on time. I was in the gang for 3 days. Three hardcore days. People think you just joined the gang like that. It ain't like that. You had to do stuff for them to respect you. You know, because they were like, hey, you ready for this? Yeah, I'm ready. So then jumping on the crackhead, and just to show them I was real, I hit the crackhead in here with a garbage can. Bow, bust him. Bow, he bleed and stuff. And I didn't even mean for it to go that hard. And I was caught up in the moment of being a thug. What? Bow, you crazy? Y'all crazy? Hit him in the head with a garbage can. Didn't have a game. He was like, dang, little folks crazy. You hit him in the head with a garbage can. I was like, yup, I'm crazy. He gave me a gun and an 8-ball. I said, oh, this is my first day. I was cool jumping on people and doing a little thuggery. I didn't want to get, I don't have all this evidence on me. Are y'all building a case on me? What is going on in this thing? You got to stand on this corner and you got to do some hours on this corner. I'm like, well, I hope they know I'm scared of the dark. And that corner is somebody else come, but if a monster come, I ain't leave that pull on that. Fight on monster for the folks, what? So they gave my 8-ball, right? And this might be a little graphic, but I don't know if some of y'all had lives in full church, y'all might know what I'm talking about. When you get your first little 8-ball, $100 worth of drugs, you think you're gonna take over the world. You couldn't tell me I wasn't buying them. Back then it was Caprice Classic, that was a big thing. A beautiful Sable was a big time car. That night I could not sleep. I kept playing Pocket Full of Stones. I got a pocket full of stones. I was all in the mirror practicing my toughness, practicing my drug, you know, just a double move, just the hand and back, just to drop it right down. No, I was ready. I'm out there early, 5 in the morning with a cup of coffee. Professional thug.
And I have my marketing strategy together.
All my stuff already lined up. I was out there. Ready rocks. Ready rocks. Boulders for your shoulders. Biggest rocks on the block right here. How you doing? I'm Meechie. It's my first day out here. Would you like to get a rock, sir? All right. Are you ready to work? I see you later on. Hey, what's your family? Hey, how the kids doing? When you drop them off, come back out of here, okay? I'll see you later. Was out there a whole day. Made enough money to give me a brand new pullover coat. I bought the coat because I had a secret zipper compartment in it. And I'm thinking, man, when I finish selling my little drugs and have a little money, I need a secret zipper compartment because I got to go in the house of my grandma there. It's hard to sell drugs if you got a grandma, especially a nosy grandma in the window. What? Nosy in the window, and then, you know, since she had a little station wagon, he was like, you know, they yell for the police and they yell for my grandma's station wagon. That was two things. My corner y'all had to watch. I said, look, y'all. Let me go to jail, but if y'all see that station wagon, if she get close, shoot me. Shoot me dead. So I come in the house, a real hard thug. I've been selling rocks all day. Watch. Brand new pullover coat. Watch. Out there, my grandma, I'm on the battlefield playing loud. All the lights are on, 1 a.m. Big Bible on the table. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I walk past like I, you know, like I was a thug. It ain't bother me. What church bounce off me? I'm what the set of rocks, what? She cut it off. I said, where'd you get the coat? I said, look, you need to mind your business. I'm folks. I'm telling myself, man, we got the money. Well, we bust him out of here to crack it. The garbage can, I was folks today. She got up, snatched the coat off me from the bottom, like, you know, like one snatch, like all I felt was arm snatch up like that. Cause I was like this, and it was like, oh. I said, she'd never find dope and money in the secret zipper department. I think she's gonna go through the pocket. She didn't go through the pocket. She found a lump by filling the coat, had some scissors next to the Bible, cut the coat in half. Got to the dope and the money, cut the dope and the money up, flushed it down the toilet.
I'm saving you from the streets.
Call the Holy Ghost.
Everything.
I'm saving you from the streets. I said, Grammy was safe, but that was killer T money. And you always told me to tell the truth. So I'm going to tell you what you did to the dog and the money. That ain't on me. It's my first day working. I was a good employee. I punched it on time. I bust somebody here with a garbage can. You got really messed up. You put the house in danger. That's what you did. She wasn't scared. The next day, she take me to the bank, get the money out. You know what I mean? I'm like, damn, the folks strong. My grandma got the money out the bank. What? She get the money, pin into my pocket, right on the block. Folks out here like this, dirty babies, pit bulls, just like this. This is how the block looks. She got the station wagon. Which one I'm killing too? I'm scared of my grandma, really, so I really crying the point. Folks, you got us. Folks, right there, grandma. I had to walk up to Killer T and hand him a note for my grandma. My grandson is covered in the blood of Jesus. My grandma said, I can't be folks no more, folks. I said, man, I knew it. All this family love stuff, all this station wagon. Your grandma wanna get you back with this station wagon. Get off my block, man. Just like, you ain't for this. You ain't built for this. Right? And I'm thinking, okay, he let me out. I ain't folks no more. What? It wasn't over. My grandma now sitting on the station wagon with a stitching cord. You wanna be a gangster, but you peeing in the bed, huh? That's how you get the dog. And I'm gonna do this thing for your dog. You think you tough? You think you tough? That little girl took your football to Sunday school. You just crack. Now I'm in the back of the stage, you at. Let's say back to the folks. And I do not join the gang again. Thank y'all for that.